Hey, this is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal here at Long Beach Lenny. Today's show is brought to you by InvestTrustDeeds.com. InvestTrustDeeds.com, give them a call for all your real estate and financial needs. Also, be sure to give them a call for great rates of return on investment. You can reach Corrine. That's Corrine at 702-214-4700. 702-214-4700. 702-214-4700. Hurry up and give her a call right now. Ask about high rates of return on investment. Also, all your real estate and financial needs. That's investtrustees.com. Tell them the Circus sent you. All right, also a big welcome to everybody listening in on iHeartRadio, our NBC Sports affiliates from coast to coast, and of course those watching us live on Facebook Live as well. Lenny, what's going on in New York, man? I hear there's some mayhem going on, and yet another legendary name is back from the dust.
I'll tell you, this is a big legendary name. Are we talking about the legendary New York Mets giving a hire to Marisol Castro? That's not the big name, because she's not related to Fidel Castro. That would be Colin Cosell. Colin Cosell, the grandson of Howard Cosell, both of them now. Marisol and Colin are going to be the new PA announcers for the 2018 season for the Metropolitans.
No!
Another Cosell? Haven't we had enough of that? I mean, sure, we had maybe a 35-year break or whatever it was, but it kind of sticks in your brain, and you just can't get it out of your head. It's Howard Cosell. However he did it, I don't know and I don't care. I don't care to hear it again. And I don't want to hear a grandson, a nephew, whoever it is, whatever, doing the same act as that guy.
There will never be another Howard Cosell, but for those of us that grew up with him and those of us that are behind that era that have heard of him, any of you kids that might be listening that are millennials, going back down the family tree there, you listen to the iconic highlights of Howard Cosell.
No.
Absolutely brilliant.
No.
Look, before they had ESPN, for those that are listening that don't know, before they had ESPN highlights, everybody was absolutely glued weekly to Monday Night Football. And why is that? Because at halftime, you would get the Cosell halftime highlights.
No, it wasn't because of
him. Yes, you would.
No, it wasn't
because
of him.
Yeah, a large part of it. A large part of Monday Night Football was because of Howard Cosell and what he was about to say.
No, people were stuck listening to him. They had no alternative. There was no internet. There was nothing. It was Howard Cosell or death.
They wanted to listen to him, Sal. I can remember as a youth, the 70s, listening to him when suddenly, out of nowhere, O.J. Simpson getting loose in Buffalo. Everybody loved that.
No, speak for yourself. Everybody did not love that. Guaranteed everybody did not love that. People loved guys like Don Meredith. Oh, yeah. But they did not love Howard Cosell.
Look,
Are you out of your mind?
Exactly, Sal, because you must be out of your mind. Look, they have a great family tree coming out of Cosell. Look, for those that don't know, Greg Cosell is actually an NFL analyst, senior producer for NFL films right now.
Because you hear him every day on TV or every week on TV, don't you?
No,
you don't. If he was that good, he would be anchoring something now, wouldn't he?
Well, now we have the grandson of the great departed Howard Cosell. Look, Howard Cosell was a lawyer, Sal. Howard Cosell had a vocabulary that was so immense, okay? The Raider fans would actually be paralyzed with all of his knowledge that he had. He was great. Yes, here we go.
No, he was. Look, he may have had a big vocabulary, but most of the listeners didn't even know what he was saying. And when he used those $10 words in a 10-cent sentence, it just pissed everybody off. Nobody could understand him, and nobody really liked his point of view except Long Beach Lenny. I don't know anybody else that liked Howard Cosell.
Okay, can we say three words here, Sal, that are iconic with Howard Cosell? How about down goes Frazier? Are we forgetting all of the championship boxing that Howard Cosell also did? Anybody who drops off of the family tree, off of his lineage, his golden tongue from the microphone, that name carries a lot of weight, Sal. That name carries more weight than Bartolo Colon after a buffet meal, okay? There's a lot carried on with Howard Cosell's name, and if this grandson has any type of a golden throat like Howard Cosell, wonderful to hear. So you're a little bit remiss there, Ringmaster, in not mentioning his boxing analysis, which lasted for absolute decades, and he made Muhammad Ali much of what he was, and you know that.
Oh, okay, so what you're saying is Cosell was in the ring making Ali or Cassius Clay. You're trying to say that he actually made him? That's like saying Kenny Albert made Patrick Kane. I mean, that's just stupid. It's complete lunacy. How dare you say that?
No, you are out of your mind. Absolutely out of your mind for this. That is laughable. Your argument on that is absolutely laughable because here we have an iconic legend with Howard Cosell. One slip, Sal, one slip, and you know what that was on a Monday Night Football game. Look at that little monkey go. And that was it. Once he said that, he was toast after that. But what a shame because – and yes, Muhammad Ali.
Well, it was taken out of context for sure.
Him sparring back and forth verbally with Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali gave him so much ammunition back and forth with those two guys. That was a great sparring match of words. Muhammad Ali with a big mouth and Cosell with a polished, refined vocabulary. It was that offset that made them a good duo.
A polished, refined, bigger mouth is what you're trying to say.
And that's great. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong to say that Howard Cosell was boastful. Howard Cosell was arrogant.
Boastful.
Everybody knows that
he was. Wait, when you say boastful, now you're really confusing the Raider fans. They don't have no idea what boastful means.
Bragging. He bragged a lot.
He's braggadocious. They might know what that means.
And that's fine. You know, look, Howard Cosell, this is great. Colin, if Colin can do that, look, this Marisol Castro, she's on television, that's fine. She has notoriety from doing, like, Good Morning America, whatever.
Who cares?
But then this kid, Colin, he's got a lot of pressure on himself. He's got an enormous amount of pressure with that name getting him in the door. Now he has to perform. And I hope the kid does. I hope the kid performs really well, and I hope one day that he's on network television, and I can just get it, package it, and throw it in your face.
No, never! We don't want anything like that. No, not another Cosell. We don't need one. We've had plenty. Folks, we'll be back in just a few minutes right here on the Sports Circus. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come.
Hey, this is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal here with Bill Clement. We have special guests
Robert F. Kennedy Jr.,
billionaire Jeff Hoffman,
Mike Golick,
Tom Flores,
John Stockton,
David Meltzer, Jim Tunney, Roger Craig,
Andre Reed,
Mario Andretti,
Herschel Walker,
Roy Firestone,
Mike Haynes,
Kevin Green,
Brian Urlacher,
Tim Jeffcoat,
Rod Jaworski,
Al Bubba Baker,
Brett Saberhagen,
Rich Cho, Markey, Charles Smith, Danny McClain, Yank Berry, Grant Fear,
Paul Dvorsky,
President of the Vegas Golden Knights, George McPhee.
Len Komoroski, CEO of Cavaliers.
Blake Greene.
Mickey Suda.
Art Steele.
Tom Beebe.
Ken Solomon.
Tom Dreesen.
Pat O'Connor.
Alan Glist. 43 Tony Awards.
Walt Harris.
Mike Crawford, President and CEO of the Hall of Fame.
Louis Fiola, President, Paramount Famous Production. Universal Worldwide Home Entertainment. Universal Studios Home Entertainment.
Glenn Berman.
Randy Fung.
The Professor.
Dr. Tommy John.
Dave Robertson.
Pat Williams.
Brandon Schneider.
Henry Bibby.
Mike Bibby.
Tim Donaghy.
Dan Hughes.
Marcus Johnson.
George Lynn.
Larry Sanders. Steve Berlander.
Dr. Jen Welter.
Steve Lavin. Gus Parrott.
Craig Colquitt.
Paul Shortino.
Des, my life is just a party and parties weren't meant to last. Dickerson.
Jason Hook, guitar player for Five Finger Death Punch.
Craig Bartok, lead guitar player, songwriter for Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Heart.
Sidney Justin from The Miracles.
My name is Curtis Blow. Basketball is my favorite sport. I like the way they dribble up and down the court. I'm here on the Sports Circus.
Vinny from the Bronx Wanderers.
Mark Schulman, drummer for Pink Cher, Velvet Revolver, Stevie Nicks, Sheryl Crow, Simple Minds, Richard Marx.
Aaron Fink, Breaking Benjamin.
Jason Hartlett, drummer for rock legend Ted Nugent.
Matt Starr, drummer for Ace Frehley from Kiss.
Rockstar, Todd Kearns.
Bill Buckman, the bass player in the rock band Fuel.
Dave Laurie.
Neil Donnell from the band Chicago.
This is Brad Gillis from the band Night Ranger. And
Philip Bailey.
Wizards, the Wizards that we.
Yeah. 8-time Grammy Award winner, top 100 greatest drummers of all time.
Kenny Aronoff with John Fogerty, Paul McCartney, Ringo Starr, and Elton John, Stevie Wonder, Dave Grohl, Joe Walsh, John Mellencamp.
John Deddy, drummer for Slayer, Anthrax, Testament, Volbeat.
Mitch Malloy, I'm the lead singer of Great White.
Pete Thorne with Chris Cornell. Melissa Etheridge.
Rob Mount, drums with Lou Gramm.
Philip Schaus, I play guitar with Accept. I play bass guitar for Ace Frehley.
Todd Morris, the Offspring.
Ty Dennis, The Doors.
Eric Aldenius, here from Bill Addles.
Brett Jones, bass player for Vonte.
Steelheart. Fuel.
Michael Schenker Group.
Brian Trock.
Scotty McClellan.
Chris Christian.
4-time Grammy Award winner.
Heidi Merrill.
Vince Ted Patton.
Daniel Negreanu.
Greg Fosselman Raymer.
Billy Hayes.
Foz Davis.
Rashawn Phillips.
Dr. Christian Willemeyer.
NASA astronauts. Mike Mullane.
Anthony Davis.
George Stark.
Dwayne Starks.
Brian Mitchell.
Rick Upchurch.
Willie Rofe.
Jim Fossil.
Chief Schrader. Pepper Johnson.
Andre Bad Moon, a.k.a. Rise.
Brian Jordan. Bill Romanowski.
Dwight Hicks.
Jason McKee.
Michael Keller.
Fred Mitchell.
Tim Rando.
Tom Brenneman.
Barry Katz.
Brad Williams.
Dean Edwards.
Emmett Short.
Jason Acevedo.
Miss Christina Smith.
Bruce Nahan.
Lee Haney. Rick Barry. Cowboy Ninja. Lance Pegas. Anson Williams.
Don Most here.
Kevin Sorbo here.
Yes.
Dr. Peter McCullough.
Damian Jackson, ex-Navy SEAL.
Martin Carey. Tinkerbell.
Stephanie Stuckey, CEO of Stuckey's Corporation.
Bruce Perlowen, founder, Marijuana Inc., Medical Marijuana Inc., Hemp Inc.
Ronnie Nunn.
Belle Jean Henderson.
Jack Llewellyn, sports psychologist.
Susie Homemaker.
Alexander Bardo Pinto.
Bill O'Brien.
Brad Server, grandson of Curly Howard from the Three Stooges.
Chris Kemper.
Aaron Ron.
Dark Kushner.
Jose Rio in the house.
Greg Olson.
Matt Joyce.
Jim Leyritz.
Brad Coleman.
Janelle Burst. Santana Moss.
Vance Johnson.
Donnie Shale.
Larry Bubber. Cole. Eddie Murray.
Wesley Woodyard.
Dexter Irvin. Colin Fraser. Andrew Ladd.
Dustin Penner.
Brian Killingsworth.
Bart Oates. Don Horn. Ryan McNeil.
Von Kirkland.
Chucky Okobie.
Jackie Sherrill. Eddie Meter.
EJ Speed.
Jesse Wujin.
Dave Murhar.
Pete Todd.
Bob Grant.
Dan Pastorini. Mark Fleming.
Brad Hopkins.
Lee Steinberg. Steve Watson.
Dan Vincent.
Mitzi Jolin. Karen Laurie.
Bo Kimball.
Len Elmore.
Kirk Brown.
Aubrey Huff.
Chuck Jones.
John Nylon.
Mandy Van Slyke.
Matt Starr. Dr. George Gauthier.
Very sure.
Jesse Sapolo. Dana Stubblefield.
Jeff Rago.
Jeff Jager.
Gino Toretta. Jim O'Brien. Kerry Justin. JT Thompson. Jim Everett. John McLaren.
Brad Boone.
Mel Stottlemyre.
Valen Massengale.
Francisco Dawson.
Kurt Sandoval.
Matt Gracie.
Bailey Brom. Leonard Marshall. Gary Reasons.
Doug Plank.
Everson Walls.
Jim McNally.
Shemmy Shem Beckler.
Kurt Walk. Leroy Irvin.
Icky Wood.
Tyrone Poole.
Alicia Thompson. Chris Duhonker. Scott Petrick. Bruce Crampton. Bush Bear, Joe Koff, Kristen Rhodes,
John Jusko,
Mayor Carolyn Goodman,
John Lee, Mayor of North Las Vegas,
Amy Wilson,
Nick McKay, voice of Salem Saberhagen, the Talking.
Talking Cat from Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
The father of the first family of drag racing.
John Ford.
Ricky Stenhouse.
Ben Brost, the voice of stock car racing.
Robbie Will, seeking the Democratic nomination for President of the United States.
Jim Strasser, founder and CEO of Cali Strong, the California sports company. CEO of LA Gear, Nike, Oakley, Quicksilver, owner, partners of Converse.
Shea Hillebrand.
Carl McDowell.
Jamie Baker.
Carlos Munoz.
Darius Kasparaitis.
Dominic Roussel.
Bill Christie.
Emery Moorhead.
Kyle Turley.
Dave Robinson.
Jeff Bryan.
Leroy Irvin.
Eric Hipple.
Mike Jaminski. Matt
Doherty. Dan Clark. Nitro. American Gladiator.
Manny Sanguin.
Marlon Greenham.
Emery Moorhead.
Ricky L.
Kyle Washington.
Vince Workman.
Brett Lashbrook.
Chesty LaRue. Scotty Graham. Joe Robinson. Chris Dishman. Gary Robinson. Catcher Bill. Ward Brewster.
Brady Barnes.
Anastasia Valentine.
Daryl Evans. Big Theo Ratliff.
Dr. Edwards.
Adrian Goodson.
Cedric Tony.
Ricky Pierce.
Rusty Spindell. Carl Mecklenburg.
Mark Currier.
Toy Cook.
Mercury Morris.
Eric Davis. Thomas Hollywood. Henderson.
Harold Jackson.
Chris Lacey.
I'm Eric Biggert.
Rich Marotta.
Steve Lott.
Michelle Corrales Lewis.
Brace the Beast. Aleem.
Joe Cortez.
Mark Caffey. Chris Berg.
Caleb Sweethands Plant.
Bronco Billy Ride.
The Sports Circus, and I'm Mike Golick.
Okay, folks, welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal here at Long Beach 20. This segment is brought to you by Legal Shield, providing legal protection and peace of mind for less than a buck a day. Whether you got a ticket for speeding, texting and driving, a DUI, maybe somebody cross-checked you and you lost some chiclets and you need a lawyer. No problem, folks. Give the folks at Legal Shield a call, 213-245-1305, 213-245-1305. Again, 213-245-1305. Make sure you give them a call. Tell them the circus sent you, or you can also go to nocourt.us. All right, also a big welcome to everybody listening in on iHeartRadio, our NBC Sports affiliates from coast to coast, including our friends over in Honolulu on NBC Sports 1500, KHKA in sunny Southern California, KCAA, 106.5 FM, 102.3 FM, and 1050 AM right here in Las Vegas, KSHB 1400, home of your Arizona Diamondbacks, in Chicago, WCGO 1590. That is our Westwood One News affiliate. Of course, our friends up on WLVL in Western New York covering Buffalo and Toronto, 105.3 FM and 1340 AM. And Lenny, we're forgetting somebody.
And that would be the Mars Rover, people.
All right. And also our friends on Facebook Live. Hey, folks, we've got a real treat for you right now. We have two-time Stanley Cup champion for the Philadelphia Flyers, all-star centerman, played 11 years in the league, NBC Sports anchor, broadcasted five different Olympic Games, and has worked for ESPN, NBC, ABC, Versus, Comcast, Sportsnet, and TNT in the U.S., and CTV, CBC, Rogers Sportsnet, and SiriusXM Radio in Canada. Called 18 years of the NHL in the finals. New York Times best-selling author, and we're going to continue. I gave him 10 seconds, and I'm actually taking about 45. Also an actor. Yes, he was on All My Children as well. Also voice of EA Sports. It's in the game. NHL video games from NHL 07 through NHL 14, as well as 2K Sports and NHL 2K Series on ESPN, NHL Hockey. Mercy, there's so much here. Bill Clement, very, very nice to have you with us.
So now you're pretty well established that I'll work for anybody that'll hire me, right?
You're damn right!
Yeah.
Oh, great.
And just in case you think I wasn't paying attention, that number is 213-245-1305 for legal protection. And just in case I need it, I've made note of the number.
In case you lost a couple of chiclets from a cross check or a takedown from Bobby Orr, you didn't get a chance to fight back. That wasn't fair. I saw that video.
Thank you. Thank you. You're one of the few people who recognizes that. I have people say, Bobby Orr trashed you in a fight.
Oh,
it was my first game in Boston Garden, and I went into the corner with Bobby Orr, and he had maybe 8 inches of butt end of his stick, you know, up through his top hand, exposed, and he butt-ended me right in the guts when we got to the corner. So when we got to the front of the net, when you're a rookie in the NHL in the day, it's a little different now, but if you didn't stand up for yourself, somebody was going to take advantage of you time and time again. So I got in front of the net, I gave Bobby a chop and a shot, and we dropped the gloves, and I grabbed and reared back to throw one punch, and Bobby went down for the pants takedown, you know, the bear hug,
yes,
and grabbing,
yes,
the pants from behind, and he tipped me down, and it was such an honor to be able to end up with a 5-minute major with Bobby Orr in my first NHL game in Boston Garden. But the truth is, and thank you for spotting that, I wanted to fight, Bobby wanted to wrestle.
Right. Well, Bobby should have gotten the extra 2 minutes for delay the game, because he didn't allow the fight to proceed.
Well, here's how weird it was back then, though. There were guys that were so good at what they did, whether it was trying to intimidate or trying to incite, that same game, I went into the corner with Ted Green, who had suffered a horrific injury after being hit in the head with a stick. That whole deal is a long story, but Ted Green was terrible Ted Green. And I went into the corner, wasn't wearing a helmet, and I got to the bench, and I had blood running down my face, and I reached up to my head. Turned out I had a 6-stitch cut on the top of my head. And I said to the guys on the bench, I said, did you see Green hit me? And they said, no. And the refs didn't see it because there was no penalty. So the guys were so good at inflicting damage when they wanted to and doing it without catching the eye of the ref, that I came out of the corner after getting clonked on the head for 6 stitches, and nobody saw it. Maybe the people sitting in the corner saw it. Ted Green, I think, must have seen it, but that's the way it was. That was the game.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you what. This is for you, Ted Green. Yeah, not really buying that one. Fish aren't biting today, folks. So, Lenny, jump in here. I know you had a piece here for Bill.
That's right, Bill. We have something here on the Sports Circus called Take 10. It's 10 random rapid-fire questions in 90 seconds or less. Are you ready?
Why not? Let's go.
Here we go. You have to sign in at a hotel with a movie star name. What movie star will you sign in with?
Brad Pitt.
What style of car would you want to signaturize Clement's last name to?
Jeep Grand Cherokee.
You own a hockey franchise in Idaho. What are you naming the team?
The Boise Bills.
Nice.
What is your favorite TV show to watch reruns of?
A tie between Seinfeld and Friends.
What is the best holiday of the year?
Christmas.
All right. Would you take a dive in a celebrity fight in the ice rink against David Hasselhoff for charity?
Not a freaking chance in the world.
All right. Who would be a better teammate on the ice, Santa Claus or Frosty the Snowman?
Santa, because he'd probably have a few extra reindeer that we could use when we get bogged down.
There you go. All right, what superhero would you want to play in a movie?
Iron Man.
What animal, Bill, do you most represent?
A really slow moose.
And the last one is, what is the greatest decade of music of all time?
Oh, man. Are you kidding? Ugh. Look, it has to be the 60s only because that's when the Beatles, man, they They disbanded in 1969, and I just listened on XM radio to their top 100, and no two of them sounded alike. The 60s, only because the Beatles came from the 60s.
Very good.
An astounding round of applause. Bill, you're getting so much applause today. I don't know. I think we need to be paying admission.
Well, go ahead. I'll take 20%. You guys can have the rest, and we'll just ride off into the sunset.
All right. We'll set you up with a sponsorship program as soon as the show's over. Hey, let me ask you a question. Now that the Stanley Cup is going on again, and obviously you've hoisted the cup twice, I mean, what a glorious feeling that must have been. Take a fast forward to today. We've got the expansion. Holy crap. Vegas Golden Knights. And you've got the Washington Capitals and Alex Ovechkin. What are your thoughts on this? I know you played for the Caps. You wore the sweater. But take the sweater off and just give me your third party for this for a second.
I'm really happy for the Caps getting there. I love Barry Trotz. He's a great man. The franchise has paid its dues. Like one time to the finals in 44 years, you know, 1998. And you've had the greatest goal scorer of our generation. It's time for you to get there. At the same time, I believe that Alex Ovechkin is more suited to winning a Stanley Cup now. I believe that the whole franchise counted on him to get it all done. And it's not a one-guy deal, right? You guys have been watching the sport long enough. You know that hockey is not about one guy winning a Stanley Cup. So I'm happy for Ovechkin to finally get to the finals. I'm happy for the franchise. I love Barry Trotz. At the same time, my jaw just continues to stay like slack, right? I mean, season starts, Vegas Golden Knights. Little different conditions for them drafting an expansion team. We thought they would be better than other expansion teams. So they start winning early in the season. We go, off to a good start. Then the second month, it's like, oh, wow, they're still winning. And it got to third, fourth, fifth month. And finally, it was like, are you freaking serious? Are they really still winning? And are they going to make it to the playoffs the way they are? Are they going to be 13-3 at this stage of the playoffs? I said a week ago to a couple of friends, there's no way Vegas is going to lose the Stanley Cup final. There's no way. There has never been a greater team of destiny in the history of the league than the Las Vegas Golden Knights.
It's unbelievable. Now, Bill, I'm a season ticket holder, and here in the last minute, I'll finish this one up. We'll get to the next segment. I will tell you, as a season ticket holder, we had to buy in. That's 1 minute left. We had to buy in for 5 years of commitment. And I said, okay, fine. I grew up in Chicago, grew up with the Blackhawks, so I got a little spoiled with some good hockey. But we had our tough times there, too. And then when I moved to Southern California, I had 5 years of misery, the first five with the Ducks. And so here I'm in Las Vegas. I'm like, all right, I'm ready for 27 wins. But this has blown up. It's gotten crazy. It's the Island of Misfit Toys that have just come together. And, wow, do they work hard. I'll tell you what, Bill, if you could stick around with us for the next segment, we'd like to continue on with that.
Yes, sir.
All right, that's great. Hey, folks, we're going to be back in just a few minutes right here at the Sports Circus with two-time Stanley Cup champion Bill Clement and a million other credentials. We'll get to that in just a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come.
The sports world. It's a circus.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas.
You know, score, put the ball down, give it to the referee. You know, and I don't even care if you slam it down, but you don't have to dance. You don't have to call your mom on the phone. You don't have to go.
The Sports Circus is a one-hour, primetime, nationally syndicated program that's carried on ABC, CBS, Fox, NBC News, and CNBC radio affiliates, plus Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, WOW cable TV affiliates across North America and nationwide in upscale hotels and resorts on hotel television in all 210 Nielsen-rated markets.
Just like a circus. My life is just a party, and parties weren't meant to last. Dickerson.
Jason Hook, guitar player from Five Finger Death Punch.
Sidney Justin from The Miracles.
My name is Curtis Blow. Basketball is my favorite sport. I like the way to dribble up and down the court. I'm here on the Sports
Circus.
The Sports Circus brings top sports and entertainment content and is delivered fully produced and is easy pass-through traffic for radio stations. Simply drop the program in your traffic manager. The full 59-minute, 50-second file will coordinate with the clock. Your local station receives up to 4 minutes of local avails during the Sports Circus broadcast, and it's a great lead to live sports and entertainment.
Well, if you're going to talk about our congressman being crooked, why not talk about commercial products who don't do what they represent to do?
Yes! Big Billy here, he certainly knows something about making things difficult on the
God
competition.
God, he's a punisher.
Yeah, he just broke the ribs.
Yeah,
you know, I still haven't broke someone's collarbone yet in a boxing match.
That's a great statement. I have not broke someone's collarbone in the ring yet.
I've never heard that before.
I can't
is there
wait.
A reason you said
he
in
says
the
I
ring?
Can't wait.
Is it that you've broken collarbones just outside of the ring?
You did catch that, right? He said in the ring.
Yeah, exactly. So like, he got him on the curtain. He got him on the edge of the ring and broke his collarbone.
Hey, this is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
I had to get Sal's name right.
Well, that never happened.
That's
Sal the
floor sweeper. That's his new name.
Sal the bookkeeper.
But even my name, even my last name.
Add that one to the bank, you know?
But no, Alicia, you even got my last name wrong. That's why I said my name.
I know it starts with a V. It starts with a V.
He said a V. Really? Where's the punch sound? 400 punches.
Here's the punch sound.
Right. Exactly. Look, he almost knocked out the microphone.
Alicia, that's why they have cue cards, right? That's what that, you know. So don't let the name bother you. Just bring a cue card with you next time.
Yeah, but people can't read my name off a cue card.
Or change your name to Joe Smith or something. Jeez, make it easy.
Yeah. This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and remaster of the Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it on air that'll punch you in the mouth. And you'll beg for more. Also, you could call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem. Remember, folks, it's a circus, and we prove it every day.
I want to try to instill some of this winning environment for this particular team. What's been your experience? Kevin, we're going to start with you. What was your experience going from Team A to Team B and bringing that Super Bowl experience to the next team?
You know, they were kind of getting on me, wanting me to chill out a little bit, not play a game on a Wednesday and Thursday. But I always felt that, you know, you got to play at game day speed on Wednesday and Thursday so that you're instinctive and you can play on game day speed on game day.
The Sports Circus is received well on all radio formats and is currently aired on sports, news, and music stations.
Andre Reed.
Mario Andretti.
Herschel Walker.
Roy Firestone.
Mike Hayne.
Tim Jeffcoat.
Rod Jaworski.
Al Bubavich.
Brett Saberhagen.
It's a circus and we prove it every day.
Aaron Fink, Breaking Benjamin.
Jason Hartlett, drummer for rock legend Ted Nugent.
Matt Starr, drummer for Ace Frehley from Kiss.
Phil Buckman, the bass player in the rock band Fuel.
Hey, brother.
Hey, we know quality content is hard to find, so if you're ready to have the Sports Circus in your market, give us a call right now at 714-948-0100. That's 714-948-0100. Or email us at info@thesportscircus.com. That's info@thesportscircus.com. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time right here on your favorite station. Until then, so long, everyone.
Hello, Jack McDowell here, Black Jack McDowell, and you're watching the Sports Circus, which is totally cool. So you have a great time watching. Have some fun.
All right, everyone, welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm Long Beach Lenny here with the Ringmaster Sal, and this segment is brought to you by the American Business Trust Company, specializing in startup consulting, sales and marketing, corporate strategy, and investment capital. Visit them at abtrustco.com, that is abtrustco.com, or give them a call at 657-600, 1-877, that is 657-600, 1-877 for all your business needs. Tell them the circus sent you. And we want to give a big welcome to all of our iHeartRadio and NBC Sports affiliates from coast to coast. Right now, we have a special guest in the house. We have a multiple Stanley Cup champion. We have a qualified NHL announcer, pitch man, you name it, NHLer, Bill Clement. And Bill, I got a question for you here, okay? Since I wanted to find this out. Okay, now you just said that the other teams are suited more for the Stanley Cup playoffs. But, you know, come on. There's a lot of people that are listening to this. It's great that there's just a fairy tale story of the Vegas Golden Knights, but somebody like me that's a Kings fan, I'm just banging my head saying we got swept four by this team of misfits and who knows who they are. I mean, is this really great for the game, or could it have been better to maybe have Nashville sitting in there once again on a back to back going against Ovechkin?
No, there's nothing better for the game than this. This is kind of like the Woodstock of hockey spread out over a whole season, right? Not a weekend, not a week, not a month, but these guys who were left exposed in the draft because their team said, we got a bunch of guys that are more valuable than you that have come together to do this. It's the greatest happening. I believe it's going to be the greatest season-long happening in the history of pro sports. Nobody has ever done this. And whatever the Vegas Knights end up getting, and I think they're going to win it all, they absolutely deserve. And I don't know how – look, I understand Capitals fans are cheering for the Caps. I get that. They've paid their dues. But when you consider the St. Louis Blues came into the NHL in 1967, all right, that's a couple of years ago. They've never won the Stanley Cup. And here are the Vegas Knights in year one, and people go, wait a minute, how the hell did this happen? Believe me, that's what 30 general managers in the NHL are asking themselves now. How the hell did this happen, and how do we get it to happen in our rink? So this is turning the entire sport of hockey on its ear, but I believe in a good way. How can you not pay attention to what's happening right now? I'm serious. How can you not pay attention to it?
How could you not buy into what's going on right now on top of it? I'm wearing a Kool-Aid shirt. I'm drinking the Kool-Aid, Bill.
Good for you. What happened to the LA Kings, though? Well, here's the great – here's what is tormenting general managers. The Vegas Knights are 13-3, right? So they're sweeping their way through the playoffs, and general managers are going, how close are we? Or how far are we, right? Are we as good as we think we are? Are we horrible? How do we make any sense of this? And if there's one GM or one hockey person that could sit down and say, I got it figured out, they're lying. They're lying. Nobody has this figured out yet.
Hey, so, Bill, I'm going to put you in the Wayback Machine here. I've got a question for you. You might enjoy this one. Go back to the 1975 Cup Finals, Game 3 at the Odd. The legendary fog game. I want to know about the fog game, and I want to know about the bat and Jim Lorenz and the evil omen.
Oh, the bat game and the fog game.
Yes. Yeah, tell everybody about that.
Because first of all, it was like 90 degrees, and the Buffalo Auditorium had no air conditioning. So the climate was ripe for fog. So the fog starts as the game begins. And the refs said, okay, guys, both benches, like Flyers, Buffalo Sabres, you guys come out and skate around your end and lift the fog. Because when you create that vortex, you know, that quick moving circulation of air, the fog will lift. I said, okay. So here we go. We're skating in our end. The Sabres are skating in their end. And we're skating behind the net. And the ice sucked at the Buffalo Odd. It was chippy and cracky. And we're skating behind the net. And we had Bill Watson, Ed Van Imp, Moose DuPont, they said, hey, whoa, stop skating behind the net. You're tearing the ice up, and we're not going to be able to control the puck back here. So they said, well, skate in front of the net. And the same thing was happening at the other end, we found out later. The Sabres were saying the same thing. So we started skating in front of the net through the crease, and Bernie Perron, our Hall of Fame goaltender, said, okay, hold up a minute here, guys. You're killing the crease, and I need to stop the puck. So both teams, we went back and sat down on our benches and said, you know what, guys? We're not arena management, so it's up to somebody else to fix this. So there was, after a 30-minute delay, these kids came out of the Zamboni door with bamboo poles, one bamboo pole on one side of a sheet and the other bamboo pole with another kid on the other side of the sheet, and there were these groups of three there were three groups, two kids each. They came out with these bamboo poles, like, hooked up with sheets as sails, and they skated around the ice, and they actually were able to lift the fog, and that's how we were able to continue. One of the greatest high-tech solutions, right, to fog, which is kids on skates with bamboo poles and sheets. So as the game progressed, a bat came down and started dive-bombing a face-off circle with Rick McLeish and Jimmy Lorenz going to face-off. And the linesman wasn't dropping the puck, and this bat was really harassing them. And at one point, it came and took another swing by, and Jimmy Lorenz just reached up with his stick and went, help, popped the bat, knocked it down, knocked it cold onto the ice. And at that point, the linesmen started looking at one another saying, I ain't going to touch it. Jimmy Lorenz, I ain't going to touch it. Our guy, number 19, Rick McLeish, who was tougher than nails, he said, I got no problem with that. Just reached down, he had his glove on, picked up the bat, took it over to the penalty box, threw it in the penalty box, and the face-off ensued, and away we went. But I got to tell you something. Years later, Jimmy Lorenz told me that for years he got hate mail from animal rights people. And I felt so bad for him. I mean, look, we just wanted to play, right? And nobody else was taking care of the damn bat. And poor Jimmy got hate mail for years from animal rights people. That's not right.
Now, he should have shot it in the net anyway, just because. And, you know, then there would have been some kind of a, you know, if by chance Buffalo would have won, then people would have thrown during the cup finals, the oncoming cup finals, whatever, they would have thrown bats on the ice like they do, you know, in with the octopus and the rats and all this other garbage and the catfish in Nashville.
Like that. That's a great idea. I'm sorry the NHL stopped the rats. I called the game in Florida when the Panthers went to the finals against the Colorado Avs, and game four went to triple overtime, I don't know, double overtime, whatever it was. Gary Thorne and I are calling the game, and everybody had their rats, but it was 0-0 going into overtime. Colorado wins, and everybody emptied their pockets, their purses, their backpacks, and threw thousands of rats on the ice. Of course, we were signing off, right? All TV was kind of going away. We had to do a wrap-up. I went down onto the ice and literally had to wade through these, you know, rubber rats, you know, whatever they were made of. And I picked out the two prettiest rats and took them home to my kids, who were only 6 and 7 at the time. But I miss those days. I miss the rats.
Quick question here for you. We always talk about Ovechkin and the power that he has in scoring. Do you feel realistically that he could catch or pass the great one?
No.
Thank you, Sal.
I don't think he'll play that long.
No.
Sal.
I wish the rules would change so that we would enhance scoring opportunities. And you know what? For years, it's like, okay, the goaltender's equipment is going to shrink. That's a bunch of crap. It never has. The goaltenders have so much say. Wayne Gretzky scored 92 goals in a season. I would love to live long enough to see at least an 80-goal scorer, right? But it won't happen in today's game. Everybody blocks shots. Everybody sacrifices for defense.
Oh, yeah.
And that's cool. But I love offense, man. I mean, in the day,
well, you got
when
the trap, you got
80 goal scores, I was all in.
Except, well, think about it.
I wasn't one of them.
Bill, you've got the left wing lock, you got the trap, you got all kinds of traffic in the neutral zone, and that's really clogging things up. You're not going to see that 70, 80 score anymore. Ovechkin does have a chance if he scores 50 his next five, and he's been doing it, so why not? Hey, listen, we're kind of running up against the clock here. Tell everybody real quick in a minute about your speaking engagements. I want everybody to find out as much as they can about Bill Clement. Go ahead. Take it away.
Oh, thanks. Thanks. Anybody that wants to know anything about what I have going on besides broadcasting, I still do Flyers games on NBC Sports Philadelphia. But just go to Bill Clement, and that's cement with an L in it, BillClement.com, and it's all there. I've written a book on leadership. It's autobiographical, but I've converted it into an audio book, and really enjoyed doing that. I did the narration myself, and I speak. I do keynote addresses around the country regularly, so BillClement.com. If anybody wants to figure out or see a little more about what I do, that's where to find it.
Yeah, folks, this is a guy that is incredibly accomplished, from hoisting the cup twice to being an anchor. I mean, all over the world, covering damn near everything. This guy has done it all. Make sure you follow him. Go to BillClement.com. Check him out. He's a New York Times bestselling author on top of it. actor, voiceover guy. He's done it all. Even if you play video games, if you're in the younger crowd, trust me, you've heard him on your video games from the NHL games as well. So, Bill, a pleasure having you on. And if you have a social media account, real quick, shoot it out there.
Yeah, Bill Clement 10, Twitter account at Bill Clement 10. You can locate me on Facebook, too. I'm pretty well everywhere. Fortunately, not many people have my name, so if you just, you know, wherever you go social media wise, just go Bill Clement and I'll show up.
All right, pleasure having you on, Bill, and we'll be back in just a few minutes on the Sports Circus. Don't go anywhere.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm Roy Firestone. Now it's time to throw it back to Sal.
My favorite one had to do with the Green Bay Packers. And I love the fact that they dealt off Ty Montgomery because of a blown assignment. Green Bay isn't Green Bay unless they have a good running game. Then they can win 10 Super Bowls. The fact is, you don't have a running game, you've got 70% passing, and that's not where Aaron Rodgers needs to be. He needs to be in a position where he's got a running game to offset the passing game and so forth. I like the move. Green Bay didn't have a running game anyway, so all they're doing is saying, we're going to get rid of you because you don't follow instructions.
Well, he made one of the most boneheaded plays I've ever seen. There's 2 minutes and 5 seconds on the clock. They traded him on Tuesday.
They should have cut him on Sunday
night. He shouldn't have been on the plane back to Green Bay.
Right, they should have made him walk back to Green Bay.
No, it was a terrible play. Now, he's not a stupid guy. He went to Stanford. Really? He's not a dumb guy.
He's not a dumb guy, but he doesn't follow instructions.
He made a terrible play.
The fact is, he didn't follow instructions. And you say he's not a dumb guy. His own agenda he put ahead of his team.
I agree.
Thus, he is a dumb guy. Right or wrong?
Wrong. He just got selfish. You're not going to convince me that a guy from Stanford's a dum-dum.
No!
this is Sydney Justin from the Miracles.
So you heard yesterday's show at Roy Firestone. You think you hear a little clip about him going into the office where Smokey was at? And that was really good material, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was really funny, man.
Yeah, and then you heard him.
It was hilarious. It was cool, though. It was cool. Really cool story, man. I enjoyed listening to that.
Right, and then he gave a little bit of a couple of bars. Can you give us a couple of more from Ooh Baby Baby? And let's see if you could do it better than Roy Firestone. Come on, man.
You know what? Why not? I did you wrong. My heart went out to play, but in the game I lost you. What a price to pay. Hey, I'm crying. Ooh, baby, baby. How's that, man?
That's
Is that okay? Is that
man.
Good enough?
That's incredible.
That's fantastic.
You know why? Because that's what you do. You're in the incredible business, Sid. That's awesome. Yes! Only at the Sports Circus. You're going to get sports. You get music.
Welcome back to Sports Circus with Joe Cortez, International Boxing Hall of Fame referee.
I'm Long Beach Lenny. The ringmaster is out on assignment, the hockey assignment. So this part of the program is brought to you by Cali Vegas, helping people just like you create and host your very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk show. Cali Vegas can help you with everything you need to get out of sitting in hours of traffic every day and hosting your very own talk show in your very own studio. How do you do this? You call Cali Vegas at 949-445-1119. That number again, 949-445-1119, or visit them at CaliVegas.com. Cali Vegas, have them make you a star. And we want to go ahead and give a big shout out to all of our iHeartRadio and NBC Sports affiliates from coast to coast. People, if you want to get up close and personal, find out a lot more about the Sports Circus and who our upcoming guests are, please visit us at thesportscircus.com. Also made it easy for you to stay connected on Twitter and Facebook. Simply search us on The Sports Circus. Right now, I'm looking at baseball. We're looking at the Yankees and Houston, two division leaders right now, two powerhouses. You have pitching going against firepower right now. Right now, we have that firepower leading 5-2. Hey, Houston, do you have a problem? What's happening with them? Running into the Yankees, other than, like, what is it? If you don't have Verlander on the mound, they're pretty vulnerable. And I'm thinking that if they run into some hot teams from the East here, they're running against the Yankees, they go up against the Sox, the Red Sox, they go up against anybody other than the White Sox, then they're going to go ahead and have some trouble. They're going to have some trouble right now. Speaking of trouble, hey, Cub fans, do you see that Hugh Darvish has a right tricep inflammation? Ow! How does that taste? How does that feel? There's not enough cortisone and belly-aching tears to be able to remedy that tricep right there, considering that you're paying the guy over $20 million. That's where you got to get the pinky finger up, and you're like, $20 million, like Austin Powers, Dr. Evil. It's a lot of bread to be getting out to a guy like that. But wait, there's still good news. There's good news that the Dodgers, yeah, Maeda to the disabled list with a hip strain. What are their better pitchers going down right now? What in the world has happened to the Dodgers this year, people? I mean, look, I know that I bashed them quite a bit, but look, a team that came out of the World Series, don't you think that team should have enough talent, harnessed enough talent, maybe in their farm system off their bench, that they could be able to muster up some power, muster up some grit, be able to win some games and pull it out instead of getting swept by the Cincinnati Reds not too long ago in a four-game series? Got to be able to show us something over there, people. You know, I mean, look at the standings right now. Yeah. Okay, so are the Dodgers creeping up? Yeah, they're creeping up. But just the other day, we were saying, hey, they're only 3.5 back, now 4.5 back. Soon that they'll be back to the wall. Who knows with that team? You got the Central. You got a little bit of a separation with the Milwaukee Brewers. But here you still got the Cubbies. Got them Cubbies, Cub fan. You still got the St. Louis Cardinals in it. Pittsburgh Pirates are fading. And they gave away McCutcheon, and that team is fading fast right now. And then you still have the Miracle Mets. What happened to them? The Mets are just struggling. Man, look at them. They were world beaters at the beginning of the season. They had that one stretch where they were 13-2, had like a 7-game lead on the Nationals. And now look at the Nationals right now, Bryce Harper and his flowing long locks of Thor, that they are like just a mere scant half game out of first place behind the Atlanta Braves. Oh, I love that tomahawk chop when they do that. If they dare protest that, I mean, they're already getting rid of the engine that belongs on the face of the Cleveland Indians. Got rid of the Indian off of their logo after this year. That's a disgrace. Why did they even let that happen, people? How would you like it if it was your mascot? You know, they're not going after my team. They're not going after the Angels. They're not going after the Angels for fear that they'll have earthquake floodings and lightnings coming in there, or a lava volcano just ripping up in the middle of Burbank if somebody went up there and lawyered up and tried to protest Artie Moreno and the Angels of Anaheim. Yes, Sal, it's Anaheim Angels, all right? So nobody's going to pick on our name. The Mariners, is somebody going to go, oh, let's get rid of the Mariners? You're disrespecting. How about let's get rid of the Astros because you're offending the universe. You're offending the entire universe of the cosmos and the galaxy. What about the black holes in the universe? You're offending them. So we have to get rid of the Astros name now too. And the Rangers. Athletics, Oakland. Oakland Athletics. You know, you're that's not insulting to anybody. You can keep that name. The White Sox. Gotta get rid of that. That's a dumb name. How about let's just call it as it is? Red Sox, White Sox. I'm gonna go down the league, dumb or not dumb. And Cub fan, if you're there, you can go ahead and chime in on this too. Boston Red Sox, dumb. A dumb name for a baseball team. New York Yankees. Okay, now that's historic. We're going to keep the Yankees. Tampa Bay Rays. Okay, now look, they changed them. They modified them. Tampa Bay Devil Rays. Now they have to be the Rays. So people are just thinking those big manta rays that are out there in the ocean. Fine. Toronto Blue Jays. We're letting Toronto keep their name because Toronto's insignificant. Okay, Toronto is O Canada. They're the only team up there, and we're just sparing them any grief of protest as long as they keep their natural coal coming to our, you know, area and whatever thing that we have, Grey Goose, vodka, whatever they make, send it our way, and you can keep your name. The Baltimore Orioles, they're safe. The Orioles are safe. That's fine. It's a proud bird. Fine. Detroit Tigers, oh, okay, animal activists now. Rawr! People that eat Frosted Flakes, they're offended now because of the Tigers. We got to get rid of their name. The Minnesota Twins, gone. We got to get rid of that because people that are twins, the triplets are being offended, and all the single-digit births in the world. The Royals. Kansas City Royals, fine, keep it. White Sox. I've already gone over the White Sox. That's a dumb name.
Boo.
Is that agreed? Cub fan, White Sox?
Terrible name.
All right. So are we keeping the Nationals or get rid of them, Cub fan?
I think that name is too easy. Kind of mailed it in.
You're right. You're exactly right. They mailed it in. You're gone, Nationals. Okay, Philadelphia Phillies, Cub fan.
Again, mailed it in.
Mailed it in. That's right. The Phillies. It just sounds too simple.
Why don't they just call them the home team homers?
That's it. And here's the one that I'm on the fence about. The Metropolitans, the New York Mets. Now, they shorten it. Don't they cheapen it by shortening their name? Metropolitans?
Indeed, they do. Anything Mets related is wrong.
And they should have been called, like, maybe the Neapolitans because of their colors that they have. They should have just gotten Neapolitan colored uniforms. Miami Marlins. Now, Cub fan, aren't we being offensive to the fish in the ocean now?
Possibly.
Possibly. I mean, what? Look, you know, the tuna. The tunas are offended now. Why weren't they? The tunas are saying, hey, step up. You know, we're the most consumed fish on the planet. Why weren't we the Miami tunas? The Brewers. Oh, Cub fan, that's close to your heart, man. Milwaukee Brewers. You keeping that?
Hate the team, love the beverage. I say it's a good name.
That's right. We got to keep that one. Cardinals. Cardinals.
Terrible.
They're a bird. Come on, Cub fan. They're a bird.
That's the state bird of Illinois anyways, so.
So they're gone. All right. The Pirates, we got to keep. Keeping the Pirates.
Yes.
The Reds. The Reds must be gone. The Reds need to be banished just because they need to be banished. The Dodgers need to be gone because the Dodgers got their name from Brooklyn. So I think anytime that you switch cities, you need to be able to change your name. Arizona Diamondbacks are going to stay, people, because that's a venomous snake, and there's something cool about that. Colorado Rockies is gone. That was a cheap name. That was the easiest name right there. San Francisco Giants. Well, unless they actually played like Giants, they should keep their name. Other than that, they should be like the San Francisco Fog. Because they're always fogged in over there. And then San Diego Padres, I don't know. You can't say anything about the Padres. And then the Cubs, Cub fan. Stick up for your Cubs real quick.
Baby Bears. Gotta,
Baby Bears.
Gotta learn how to grow up.
Cuddly and Cute. You can't get rid of Cuddly and the Cute. And the best name is God's Team, the Angels. People, thank you so much for listening to the Sports Circus. We had fun with you. We're going to be coming back with the next show on your same station. Keep yourself dialed in, and we'll see you next show. Have a good one, people.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average and best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at UppercutChops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at UppercutChops.com.